In this video, you are going to see a detailed tutorial on how to automatically share other websites' content using the Revive Network plugin. I'll cover the whole process from zero to checking out your queue of scheduled social media posts, so keep watching. Hi, my name is Robert and I make WordPress video tutorials and reviews on this channel for beginners and advanced. If you enjoy the content and find it helpful, please consider subscribing. Sharing other people's content on social media is a great way to get noticed and build a stronger social network. With that being said, doing it manually is a huge time sink, which is why it can be helpful to find a way to automatically share other websites' content on your social media accounts. While there are non-WordPress tools like Buffer, the Revive Network plugin lets you automate the whole process without having to ever leave your WordPress dashboard. So, let's see it in action. Before moving on, you'll need to actually install and activate the Revive Network plugin. Because I talk about a premium plugin here, you'll need to upload the zip file that you get after purchasing the plugin. Once you install and activate it, enter your license key by going to Settings, General, and scrolling down to the Revive Network license area. Once you've got the plugin activated, you are ready to start setting it up. The first thing you need to do is creating a Twitter or Facebook app. I'll show you the steps for the Twitter app, but remember that you can always find instructions for Facebook by clicking this link. To create your Twitter app, go here and click Create New App. On the next screen, you need to fill out application details. For the first three fields, you can enter whatever you'd like. That is, the information won't be seen by anyone but you. But for the callback URL, make sure that you enter the following. Then, click Create your Twitter application at the bottom. On the next screen, click on the Keys and Access Token tab. From there, you'll need to copy the API key and API secret into your Revive Network dashboard. Paste those values into the relevant boxes and click Save Settings. Next up, head to the Accounts tab. Here, you'll need to connect your actual social profiles. You'll only see options for the network that you created an app for. For example, I only created a Twitter app, so all I see here is an option to add a Twitter account. To get started, click the Add Account button. Assuming that you are logged into Twitter, all you need to do is click the Authorize App button. Okay, now you are ready to start adding feeds for the content that you want to share. RSS feeds are what actually allows you to automatically share other websites' content. Basically, you'll need to find the RSS feed for the blog content you want to share. Generally, because most blogs are based on WordPress nowadays, a neat trick is to just append /feed to the end of any WordPress site's URL to find its RSS feed. Once you have the feed you want to share content from, go to the Feed tab of Revive Network and fill in the options. Feed name is purely internal, so make it something that's easy for you to remember. And the feed URL is where you enter the direct URL to the RSS feed you found. Twitter handle is where you enter the username of the account you want to mention, including the around sign. And If you link more than one of your social media accounts, you can choose specific accounts here. Once you are finished, click Save Feed. One of the neat things about Revive Network is that it lets you create one or more custom templates to structure your tweets or Facebook posts. You can also use dynamic variables to automatically insert relevant information about the post title or person you are referencing. By default, the plugin includes three templates, but you can always go in and delete those templates or add your own custom templates. To do that, go to the Templates tab and click Add New. Here's what the various fields mean. Template name is just for internal use, so make it something that's easy to remember. Check this box to use this template for Facebook posts, and check this to use it for Twitter posts too. If you want to use this template only for Facebook or only for Twitter, check that specific box. As for template content, it deserves more than a bullet point. Basically, you are going to mix plain text with the magic tags below the box. Let's say the most recent posts you are going to share is a post from Tmile titled How to Use Revive Network. If you put this in the template content box, when Revive Network uses that template, we'll automatically convert the magic tags into actual data from the post. So, it would look like this. In reality, the real URL would contain your UTM tags, but this is just an example. Speaking of, once you save your template, go to the Edit UTM Tags tab to configure them. UTM tags help your traffic show up in the analytics logs of the websites that you refer traffic to. It's a small thing, but it gives you credit for the traffic and helps influencer notice and appreciate that you are sending them traffic. By default, the plugin will fill in the UTM tags based on your site's URL. Most of the time, you can just leave this as the default. But if you want to edit them, you can do that here. Just like with the templates, you can use magic tags to insert dynamic information. The network tag, in this case, will change to Twitter or Facebook depending on the actual network that you share the post on. At this point, you are all ready to start sharing. Before you do that, though, you should tell the plugin how often you actually want to share. To do that, go to Schedule and then click on the Share Settings. Usually, you can leave this as the defaults, but if you want to configure them further, here's what each option means. Check interval is how often the plugin checks RSS feeds for new posts. The posts to share option sets how many posts to share when the plugin finds new posts in a feed. Twitter share interval is how often to wait between sharing on Twitter. And Facebook shares interval is how long to wait between sharing on Facebook. Purge post interval is where you can choose how long to store posts from a feed before the plugin clears it from the list. Now is the point when you can hit the Start Sharing button to kick the plugin into gear. Once you start sharing, you can monitor exactly what will be shared and when by going to the Schedule tab. You can also remove individual shares by hovering over them and choosing Remove Share. And if you ever want to stop sharing, just click the Stop Sharing button to put the plugin on pause. Once you configure Revive Network, it's easy to automatically share other websites' content as needed. Whenever you want to add a new source, all you need to do is create a new feed and template to quickly add that website to your repertoire. Similarly, you can quickly remove existing feeds if you no longer want to share them.